The action continues here at Sacramento. We're joined by the one and only Brain, Bobby Heenan. Welcome to the broadcast there, old Brain.
How you doing, Mr. Schiavone?
We're doing fine. Thank you very much. We still have a lot more to go, including Sting and Scott Hall in the line for the World Heavyweight Championship. But before the next match gets underway, we want to give you some very important announcements. Coming up next Monday, Nitro will originate from the Core State Spectrum in Philadelphia. Tickets on sale at the Core State Center box office and Ticketmaster. In 2 weeks, we're going to be in Winston-Salem, North Carolina at the Lock Joe Veterans Memorial Coliseum. Tickets available for Monday, March 9th at the box office and Ticketmaster. But this Saturday, February 28th, tickets go on sale for Nitro in Louisville, Kentucky. The date will be Monday, March 23rd. This Saturday, tickets go on sale at the box office and Ticketmaster. And Jimmy Hart will be at Freedom Hall in the box office this Saturday at 10 a.m. when tickets go on sale. It'll be great, Iron Mike and Brain, to come to Louisville, Kentucky on March 23rd for Monday Nitro.
Can't wait.
Home of the Kentucky Derby. At?
Home, yes, absolutely, home of the Kentucky Derby.
Did you see all the nags in that town?
Saturn, I apologize to our great fans in Louisville for that. The Brain is off and running already.
And so is this man, Saturn. Does he look ready?
So, but, you know, you go back and we talked about the encore presentation of Super Brawl 8, and it was a memorable night on many levels and on many fronts, and especially the way the program opened. Now, later on tonight, we're going to see Booker T. As a matter of fact, he'll be coming up in our next matchup. If there's any man deserving of being called a champion in this sport, and obviously we think about Sting, the World Heavyweight Champion, and his battles with the NWL, but if there's any man deserving of being called a champion, it is Booker T. We'll talk more about it when he comes out, because he had to go through not only Rick Martel, but a very tough man, this man in Saturn last night.
And he was successful on both counts, as Booker T is once again the world's TV champion. But what a showing it was by Saturn, even in defeat.
Well, you know, I've never really cared one way or the other for Booker T. I don't think he's the brightest guy around, but I will say this for him, I have new respect for the man. He proved to me that he can get out there, and he can wrestle, and he had to reach down, he did.
Cover by Saturn, and Yuji got out of that, and a little bit of respect for both men here. Both men are fine wrestlers. Saturn, obviously very bizarre. You can just look at him and tell that. The fact that he's a follower of Raven, Raven's flock, even adds him to be a little bit more bizarre as well.
Both of these men very adept at the submission style of wrestling. We expect them to use that ground attack. Lethal kicks by Yuji Nagata.
Rain, how about, I want to get your reaction to Hollywood Hogan and Bischoff storming out of the limousine. We expected when they arrived tonight they would be very angry, and they were. Made a challenge to the Macho Man for the cage match at Uncensored on March 15th. It was accepted. That's going to be a wild one. But the fact, it seemed to me that maybe there was somebody in that limousine. Did you notice that as well? Were you watching your monitor
yes,
from
the
private
was.
Dressing room?
There was definitely somebody in there. You could see an image. You couldn't tell if it was a man or woman or if they were wearing a hat, but there was a body in there. You could see a shadow move. There's something going on, no doubt about that.
There's always something going on.
I'll tell you one thing, though, when I was watching that really, really made the hair on my neck stand up, watching Rick Steiner. I mean, he just went out there and he didn't see Vincent. He went out there and saw NWO.
Yeah, it was very emotional at the end. If you could see in his face, it almost looked like he wanted to break down and cry. And one could really almost understand what Rick Steiner is going through. I mean, these two men, brothers, blood brothers, but were the greatest tag team in our sport, arguably the tag team of the 90s.
Well, Rick Steiner certainly came to the ring with purpose and just one thing on his mind, destroying the NWO. Vincent was just the first in line.
Well, it's like losing a loved one. You know, it's his family. It turned against him, and hard to swallow, I guess.
And I wonder, and fans, if you see the encore presentation, you can judge for yourself. I wonder when they got to Scott Steiner. I wonder when the deal was made. Had it been made a long time ago when Scott was, you know, doing a lot of posing, worrying more about his biceps than maybe he was winning a tag team match. I wonder when they got to him. That's a question that will be debated for months and years in this sport as Saturn comes up with a forearm shot right between the eyes of Yuji Nagata. Nagata drop toe hold, sending the man down. Nagata just shook that one off, guys, and keeps the man on the mat.
As expected, both men employing the ground attack, and right now Yuji Nagata in control has Saturn neutralized. He'll try and make it to the safety of the ropes and get the break.
We talked about being very prolific in submission wrestling, and you're seeing a little bit of it right there.
He's a very dangerous man. Very dangerous man.
Well, you can say that about both men.
Forearm Saturn. Saturn, he's got the flock with him. He's got the flock behind him. He's got Raven there. I mean, that, who knows what goes through their sick minds in an average day? How many butterflies you think are missing wings?
Lariat and a Saturn showing his power. That was not a running lariat, just from a standing position, but exploding with his legs to drive Yuji Nagata down. Nagata will hook a leg now. Nagata trying to take him off his feet.
Dragon
screw, leg whip, take him down. How about that?
Looks like that knee turned around halfway.
And you can see that Saturn is experiencing a tremendous amount of pain. You see the knee brace on the other knee. Yuji Nagata just totally in control of this matchup with Saturn.
And speaking of submission wrestling, there you see Scott Dickinson checking in here with Sander to see if, in fact, he would want to give. You know, we think of the knee, and we think of the announcement we made about Rick Martel last night and what happened to him during his match with Booker T.
Certainly was a prelude to the rest of the evening. What a physically demanding night for all the competitors involved, and we understand that Rick Martel suffered a torn medial collateral ligament knee injury. Waiting to see exactly how long he's going to be sidelined. Now Saturn explodes and nails Nagata with a series of right hands.
Certainly what happened to Martel, combined with that historic matchup last night where a man had to wrestle twice to still brag as being world television champ.
I got something to top that.
Well, I can tell you, you can see the encore presentation starting tomorrow. And what is that, Brian?
Well, I've seen wrestlers wrestle twice on a card before, but I've never seen them wrestle a championship match back to back.
Never before, ever?
No, I've never seen it where a man had to wrestle back to back.
Without any rest period in
between.
None,
he was attacked. Saturn jumped right in the ring and nailed him.
You had never seen it before because it hadn't happened before. That's what we're trying to say. It was historic, but go ahead.
I'm going to have to ask you to leave.
So what were the points you were going to make here?
I just told you, it's historic. It's the first time I've ever seen a wrestler have to wrestle back-to-back championship, two championship matches on the same card the same night. Now, what don't you understand about that?
And back to the attack once again is Saturn into the ropes. Yuji Nagata tried to hit, toss him out. Saturn bridge suplex, nicely done. One, two, no. Didn't get it.
Sonny Ono very happy on the outside there.
Very happy.
He's smiling.
Well, he always smiles. Probably got a deal in the works or something. Picked him up.
Oh!
It's a very physical confrontation we have going on here on WCW Monday Nitro. Don't forget.
Here comes the Nagata lock.
That's right. Sting still to come against Scott Hall. He went for the Nagata lock, but he was too close to the ropes. And notice how Saturn grabbed the ropes and made the momentum go right into him that time.
And it would certainly make sense. Yuji Nagata directing his entire focus in this matchup on the legs of Saturn.
Into the corner. Drop toe hold once again. He tries to hook him.
Does
the rings of Saturn put on. He's got it hooked on Nagata, and it only takes a moment or two for Nagata to say yes. In the matchup, Saturn gets a big win here on Nitro.
You know, I thought Saturn would have the advantage, but then Nagata took him down with that leg sweep. Saw the knee twist, so I didn't think he had a chance of coming back, but he did.
He stumbles away the remnants of a very physical matchup. Still to come, the World TV champ Booker T, and a whole lot more.